great, great talents of Mr. Jeff Stevenson.
Thank you. Nice to be back here. I haven't been here for about 4 years ago. I was in this club and there was a fella in the front row. He didn't laugh once. It's nice to see you again, mate. I said, that's a nice shirt, mate. I got four down. What's three across? I'll come in late while you're performing, all right? So, anyway, I said to this fella, I said, last time I was here, 4 years ago, I said, you haven't laughed once during my act. He said, it's my stomach. Every time I laugh, it hurts. I said, that must be terrible. He said, it's not too bad while you're on. How do you make a woman moan after she's had an orgasm? You wipe your willy on her new curtains. We've reached the level. Thank you. Yes. No, I'm staying on. Now, the thing is, my brother's unlucky. He's on next. I was out tonight, it cold. Do you know, it was so cold, I saw a tree frozen to a dog. I saw a flasher describe himself, and... Too deep, get back to the crap. All right, so... Because we do, we live in a weird world. I've just got back from Spain.
Never.
Yes, I was out there. You know when you're at the airport and you see all those people delayed? That's the one time they look like their passport photograph. We arrived out there the first day, 3 weeks before the hotel. And you know, it's like the first day in Spain. You're walking along, there's a fella doing press-ups. I said, excuse me, mate, she's gone. And you know, it's like the first day. You can always tell British people, first day on holiday. New training shoes. I'm walking along the beach. We booked into this hotel, rough hotel. How rough was it? I'll tell you, it was so rough. They pinched my towels. I didn't like the room. I rang down to reception. I said, I've got a leak in the sink. He said, OK, senor, just this once. Thank you. You're a good crowd. I wish I had a better act. And... Thank you. What do you mean, so do we? Charming. No, I didn't like the bed. The bed was bare, not a thing on it. I said, I'd like a sheet on the bed. He said, you not do that. Can you run around with that clap? I'll rephrase that. Now... So I've gone down to reception next morning. I called the manager over. I went, oi, over. I said, I've got a complaint. He said, what is it? I said, last night there was no toilet paper in the toilet. He says, you've got a tongue in your head? I said, I've not got a neck like a giraffe, pal. Here's one you won't get. Two lions walking through Camden, and one said, not many people about, are there? Too deep? My mate was at the zoo, he's standing there stark naked looking at the elephant, and the elephant said, how'd you eat with that? Do you know what puts me off using condoms? When you see on the packet, these condoms have been tested. Is it just me or is he? Has it put you off? I can't believe they sell them in supermarkets. I used to get mine from Safeways. I wouldn't go to MFI. One loose screw, a lot will fall apart. And it's embarrassing, save it, I've got a weak finish. It's embarrassing when you get to the checkout and they haven't got the price on them. And the girl says, Till four, Pratt with the hatch. Condoms, how much? She says, they're going up. She said, I know the function. I want to know the price. And then you look on the packet, and the fill-by date's gone. My mate won't buy me, he buys cling film. He rolls his own. Have you ever got them next week? Get them with your copy of Reader's Digest, new condom, Reader's Digest, new condom. Free copy with a new motto, introduce a member, get one free. And they've stapled them to the centre page. What's that all about? But we do, we live in a weird world. So I was out in America, different language. I walked into this bar, I said 20 fags, I was surrounded. They've got a new airport in America now, it's called the White House. See that fella last year crashed his plane into the White House? He reckoned he was on drugs. How bloody high did he want to get? I've had a weird day today. I saw a fella at the bar in Jongleurs here, and I was talking to him, and he had a broken arm, a broken leg, three teeth missing, and a black eye. And he'd never met Vinnie Jones. I got a Vinnie Jones alarm clock for Christmas. No matter what time you set it for, it goes off after half an hour. Christmas bonus this year, George Graham, he was talking to his players, the Arsenal players. He said, anything you want, lads, anything you want. The chairman has agreed to pay for holidays, anything you want. He said to the goalkeeper, Seaman, he said, what do you want? He said, I want to go to Barbados after the season finishes. He said, no problem. He said to Jensen, he said, what about you? He said, well, I'd like to go back to Sweden. He said, no problem. I wouldn't mind you going back to Sweden for a while either. He said, and what about you, Wright? And Wright said, I'd like to go to Blackpool for the weekend. He said, why? He said, well, it's the only bloody chance we're going to get this year of riding through a town on an open deck bus. Oh! I'm only joking. No. No, no. Believe me, I'm joking. I'm a football fan. I'm a QPR fan. This is new to me. No, no, please. This is unusual to me, seeing a crowd. It really is. I can't believe it. Because last year, I've got to tell you, the Irish team played well, didn't they? Didn't they play well? And I was proud of them. And I'm not Irish. Apparently, before the big game against Italy, Jack Charlton phoned the Pope up. He said, I want you to pray for us. He said, I'm too old. He said, no, pray. I can't believe we're into 1995. 1994 only seems like a week ago, doesn't it? Unbelievable what happened last year. Michael Jackson got married, I couldn't believe that. Apparently on the wedding night, the lovemaking did not last long. Well, we all know what happens to plastic when it gets heated up. If he has any more plastic surgery, he'll be singing out of his ass. I'm telling you. I like Prince. He's made out of all the parts that Michael threw away. And whatever happened to Boy George? He said, do you remember he said he'd rather have a cup of tea than make love? He woke up next morning next to Earl Grey. Too deep? Get back to the crap. All right, so... And Elton John, what about if he spent 28 grand on having a hair transplant and found out the donor was Bobby Charlton? Some strange hobbies now. I found a great way of learning to water ski for nothing. Do you know what I do? I go on national coaches and I try to use the toilet at the back of the coach. You ever done that? You sit at the back of the coach, you kick the door, you think you're kicking it shut. The door goes open, you've got 35 people going... It's It's like when you go to the toilet and you're on a plane. Why do they put frosted glass up against the window? Who at 22,000 feet is going to want to look in? And if he does, you bet your life he drinks Carling Black Label. Yes. Now, I've had some bad luck, I tell you, the last few years. I had my car broken into 4 weeks ago. I went to the police. They've got a sense of humour now, haven't they? So I've had my car broken into. The sergeant said, alarmed? I said, I'm not happy. We had gay burglars. And you? We knew they were gay. The furniture had been rearranged. There was a quiche in the oven. Mind you, my run of bad luck, it could have been worse. I could have been offered the job as a presenter on the lottery show. What are they going to do with that money from the lottery show? It's unbelievable. They should give it to good causes. Buy Anthea Turner a brain. Hey, I'm joking. Sorry, Anthea. No. I mean, when you think about it, you know, I don't know if you know, but there's a new lottery out. It's the NHS lottery. The NHS lottery. When your number comes up, you get a bed. But we live in a strange world. I was in a shop today. I walked in. I said, a pound of fillet. He said, a pound you don't. I can't believe I just did that, gang. But there you go. So I saw something unbelievable today. You won't believe what I saw today. You will be amazed. What will you be, people here at jongleurs?
Amazed!
I was in McDonald's and I saw a fella serving who never had spots. You don't want all that mayonnaise on your Big Mac. You know what I mean? What? What's the matter with you this time of a Saturday night? Come on. So McDonald's, we all go to McDonald's, yeah?
Yeah?
You know when you go to McDonald's, you walk in, you've got to speak McDonaldish. And they're all lining up, aren't they? They're from everywhere. They're like, all the contestants from Going for Gold, they're all standing there. I watch Going for Gold, that's breakfast TV for me. Thank you, run around. And you walk into McDonald's and you go, good McMorning. I want a McBurger with a McDiet Coke. Some McFrench fries, there's your McMoney. Hurry up and I'll muck off. Puts me off the food when I see that on the menu, McMuffin, I don't want that. Now, what? I've been so depressed. Oh. I have, and tonight's getting me out of it, it really is. I've been so depressed. I said to my mate, I said, you've got to get me out of it. I've got to get out of this depression. He said, I'm going to take you somewhere. It'll make you realise there are people worse off than you. He took me to a car boot sale. Now, is it me or is it what? Have you been to one of these car boot sales Sunday morning? What's it all about? People selling crap. And people buying crap. Why don't they save time? Go to the dump and swap. It's the only place now you can get a Des O'Connor LP. Did you see Des O'Connor's series last year, Pot of Gold? I'm doing the follow-up. It's called A Bag of Shit. Sorry, Des. But we live in a weird world. It's like I went on holiday with my mum and dad last year. We went on a caravan holiday to Laysdown, Isle of Sheppey. Now, I knew you from somewhere. Now, yeah, nice to see you. Anybody here been on a caravan holiday? Now, I've got to tell you, it was the first time for 18 years I've been on a caravan holiday, and I don't mean to offend you people. I don't mean to offend you people out there in satellite land. But I now know why people go on caravan holidays. For 2 weeks of the year, it makes you realise you've got a nice house. Am I right? What? What sort of holiday is that? 5 o'clock in the morning, every morning, on the roof, Fred Astaire, the tap dancing seagull. Fault. And that caravan shakes for half an hour. My wife and I, we ended up in Margate. It's like, I've got to get this off my chest. I don't care, I'm going to tell you tonight, right? I hate it. You know when you're driving along, you want some breakfast, and you're on the road, and you stop at one of those restaurants, little portions, little chef. Or the happy eater. Have you ever seen anyone happy in a happy eater? So you know when you go in these restaurants and you're on the A road, right? And you're standing there, and you're, there's about four of you in reception, and the waiter comes out, the brain of Britain. And he says, table for four. You say, yeah, all right. And you sit down, you have your breakfast, and by about half an hour later, you've got the ump. Because you don't know those other three people. And you go to these restaurants, don't you, and the waiter comes up and he says, tea or coffee? I said, I give up. What is it? This woman sitting next to me said, can you pass the salt? I said, how fast is it going? Too deep. And it's like when you're sitting there and the waiter comes up and he says to me, I said, have you got any wild duck? He said, well, we've got one we could aggravate for you. Chick Murray, 1966. And it's like when you're sitting there. Now, this is what you're going to do. If you're going to go out for a meal tonight after the show here, right, Saturday night, you'll find some restaurants around here. Eh? I tell you, I'm glad I'm not here on a Monday. It'd be terrible on a Monday. So, people at home are saying, what's funny about Monday? Should have come here. Now, the thing is, what I've got to tell you is, if you're going to go out for a meal tonight, you want to wind the waiter up, you've got to try this, right? Stevenson's tip. When you're halfway through the meal, the waiter comes up, and he always does, and he says, is everything all right? I always say, no, and I carry on eating. He said, well, what's the problem? I said, I can't sell my house. He went out, he told the manager. Manager came out, he bought my house, 120 grand, chuff. Cash. I was chuffed. Council were not so happy. I was parking my car tonight, this little boy said, do you want us to watch your car, mister? I said, it's all right, son, I've got a Rottweiler in there. He said, how's he at putting out fires? It's dodgy around here, they put away £5 a week for muggins. Too deep. All right, so I know a villain, he's really organised. He sends get well cars before they're needed. Having said that, look at the time. Ronnie Knight's been in bed 3 hours. So, Prison, I can't believe that. You see those prisoners the other week, rang a taxi to get out. I couldn't believe that. Hey, it's easier to get out of prison now, but it is to get off the M25. I was on my way here tonight, I ran over a cat. That's what the cat said, only quicker. So I knocked on this lady's door and she opened the door. She said, what do you want? I said, I've just run over your cat. She said, what did he look like? I went. She said, no. What did he look like before the accident? I went. I'm proud to be British. You British, most of you, yeah?
Yeah.
I am, and if there's any foreigners here, I'm not going to get to, but I'm telling you, I'm proud to be British. I really am. And I think we should have had the Olympics in the year 2000. Am I right?
Yes!
Manchester. Should have been in Manchester. Mind you, can you imagine? There might have been a problem. You imagine the bloke with the Olympic flame running through Moss Side? All the shop owners, oh, shit, not again. Gentlemen here, the jongleurs and people at home in Skyland, I've got to tell you this. This is why we lost the Olympics, and this is classified information. We lost the Olympics because we invited that bloke over from the Olympic Committee, and we wanted to show him how well we could organise a sporting event. Do you know where they took him? 2 years ago, they took him to that Grand National. You remember that Grand National, the one I'm talking about? But last year, no problem, they all got away. You know why? It was sponsored by Group 4. I couldn't believe that Grand National, the one where they never got away. Apparently, at the finishing line, Jim Bowen, the host of Bullseye, he was there. And when the jockey on the first horse got off, Jim said, come here. Come and see what you would have won. Still got our athletes, Linford Christie, the only man I know who leans back on a photo finish. I can't believe he won by a length. What a brave man entering the relay. Who was that fellow who got banned and sent back from Seoul, Korea to Canada just a few years ago? Ben Johnson. Because he didn't cross the white line, he sniffed it. They knew he was on drugs. He tried to date Fatima Whitbread. Do you reckon she's Colonel Gaddafi's love child? If beauty's skin deep, she's inside out. I'm telling you. The word ugly in the dictionary, you'll see a picture, and I'm joking. Who's that other fella? Carl Lewis. I reckon he was gay, the American. That's why he kept winning. Well, would you want him behind you at that speed? No, thank you. I've got to tell you, I've got a strange family. I remember when I was a kid, my little brother, he said to my mum, how do buffaloes make love? She said, how do I know? Your father's a Freemason. And I've been on this diet. I have lost 2 stone. I've been on this F-plan diet. Anybody here been on the F-plan? What a diet. Baked beans, baked beans, baked beans, baked beans. I took a bath. I had a jacuzzi at the same time. All I lost was my friends. And my daddy wants to go on it. If it's one thing that my father does not need, it is bran, roughage or fibre. When he leaves the Kazi, the wallpaper leaves with him. We have to put the canarian in the cage, and if he lives... in we go. Even the Rottweiler comes out, saying, follow that. Strange family. My father drinks a hell of a lot. Gave the doctor a sample, it had a slice of lemon in it. He's just joined Alcoholics Anonymous. He still drinks, only under a different name. He had a vasectomy, it cost him 50 quid. That was just for the search fee. The doctor said to him, do you want the operation done privately? He said, no, so they invited all his mates round, they all watched. I can remember when I was a kid, my mum, she had one of those contraceptive coils fitted. And it kept picking up CB radio messages. Can you imagine the shock on my father's face? 3 o'clock Wednesday morning, messages blaring out from under the duvet. Come in, rubber duck. And my grandma, God bless her, 92, she went to the doctors. He said, madam, I'm very pleased to tell you you're pregnant. She said, I'm 92. He said, it's marvellous. How old's your husband? She said, he's 88. He said, give him a ring. She said, I'll wring his neck. Picks up the phone, rings up my granddad. She said, hello, Wally. I'm pregnant. He said, who's speaking? He got up one morning, he got the hemorrhoids cream mixed up with the toothpaste. Yeah. He ended up with piles of smiles, receding gums and a ring of confidence. I did a show the other week for the hard of hearing, and it's good to be back. And I walked in. What? And I walked in, there's this beautiful girl dancing on the floor. So I walked up to her, I went. She went, so I had a dance with her. I went. She went, so I bought her a drink. This fella walked up to her, he went, hello, Shirl. Want to dance? She said, no, I'm stuck with this deaf fella. It's like, have you ever seen that sign, ears pierced while you wait? You imagine leaving your ears to be pierced. I've come in to pick up my ears. Yes, madam, that'd be £4.50. Pardon? It's like when you're sitting there and you're sitting on a newspaper and somebody says, are you reading that paper you're sitting on? Next time, stand up, turn it over a page, sit down and say yes. So I'm sad about what's happened to Charles and Di, I really am, because that was a great day when they got married. But what you don't know is that day, Charles's shoes were too tight. That's where he got the groan, walking around the Abbey all day going, ooh. Wee. Hello, plant. Wee. He turned round to his right-hand man, he says, what are you doing over there? He went round, thank you. He went round, sometimes I do these gags for myself. He went round the other side, he says, damn shoes are too tight. He said, well, try them with the tongue out. He's just about to get into bed with Princess Di in the honeymoon retreat. Di's in bed. She's been to Ann Summers. How many of you ladies here tonight have been to an Ann Summers party show? Yo! And we fellas, we don't mind you girls going, do we? Because we know that when you come back at 3 o'clock in the morning pissed, we're going to see the brochure. Have you seen them? The sheepdog bra. It rounds them up and points them in the right direction. Tupperware underwear, it doesn't do much for your figure, it keeps what you have got fresh. So picture the scene, Di's in bed, Charles is there, he's just about to take off his shoes, they've been giving him aggravation all day. Next door, glass against the wall, are the Queen and the Duke, cop that, they're listening. And they're listening like that. Charles takes off his first shoe. He went, oh, that was tight. Well, as you can imagine, there was confusion next door. The Queen turned around, she said, there you are, Philip, once a lady, always a lady. 4 hours later, he took off his other shoe. He said, my God, that was tighter still. And Philip said, there you are, Elizabeth, once a sailor, always a sailor. But as I said, I'm proud to be British. I mean, the last British person we want to meet on holiday is Kate Adie. And why is it we put two policemen outside 10 Downing Street 24 hours a day? He still gets out. I remember last year, I couldn't believe it, when Maggie Thatcher was in Russia and she saw the ex-president, Mr. Gorbachev. He said, I have this embarrassing mark. She said, so do I. I can't believe those Americans, because I love the Americans. I was talking to this American fellow over there in New York. He said, hey, Jeff, everything we have is bigger than yours. I said, who's been talking? He said, we have a canyon, the Grand Canyon. He said, it is so big, you can shout, hello, on Monday, and you do not hear the reply till Friday. I said, we were like that. We blew the bugle in 1939. You never heard it till 1941. Yes! What? It's America, but he came over. I'm showing him round London. I said, see that there? That's the London Palladium. One of the biggest theatres in London. He said, Jeff, we could build a theatre like that in 3 days. So see that over there? That's Harrods. One of the biggest departmental stores in London. He said, Jeff, we could build a departmental store like that in 2 days. Just then we came to Buckingham Palace. He said, holy shit, what is that? I said, I don't know. It wasn't there this morning. Well, ladies and gentlemen, and boys and girls, you're boring me now. I've got to go. I'm actually doing an extended pantomime run that's been affected by the recession. We're up in Leicester. Snow White, one dwarf. Every time the seven dwarfs are required, this one dwarf comes on, he looks in the wings. He said, you six stay there. I'll sort this out. You think the recession's over? I've got to tell you, it's still in show business. There is still a recession. There are comedians now doing doing shows they wouldn't normally do. So, no, I'm joking. No, I've got to tell you, I'm very busy, me. I've got another show to do in October. I'm doing a show all about the Jehovah's Witness. It's called Don't Open the Door. And in about 3 weeks' time, you'll be watching a variety show, ladies and gentlemen, on one of the channels, I can't say which one. And you'll see this host come on, and he'll introduce this bright up-and-coming young comic. I'll walk on. And I'll sit there for 5 minutes getting big laughs on that show. And you'll see me in your lounge getting big laughs on that show in front of 15 million viewers, in front of 500 people in the studio, in front of you in your lounge. And you'll see me getting laughs, and you'll say to yourself, he was shit that night at Jongleurs. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you've been great. I'll see you very soon. Goodbye.